Tri-Duty Christian here. Number four to kick it off. Braden Opoff, tight end, defensive back. And we have football here with the MHSAA Clear State Semifinal South Division with the return from back at the 5-yard line. Brought up to about the 29-yard line. Returned by number nine, the quarterback for the Deckerville Eagles, Brandon Patello.
It's interesting looking at this field after so many 11-man games that I've watched this year. Just the dimensions of it being such a more narrow field.
Then you can tell it just slightly a little bit narrower.
Yeah, a little bit.
But it's noticeable.
And a return for 24 yards there for Patello. Double wing, you can say the wing T version of 8-player football. Under center, handoff. Going up to number five, it looks like Austin Fritch with a carry to the left side.
Looks like there's the fullback dive. Just a quick turnaround by Patello and give it.
Gain of about 3 yards there.
Deckerville wants it. That's all they need. You get 3 yards, 3 yards, and 3 yards. Now all you need is one on fourth down. And that spells recipe for one quarter of possession before Tri-Unity will touch the football.
The clock will keep rolling, keep rolling, keep rolling. Exactly.
And that's like what we said in our pregame show. You keep the ball out of the hands of this high, potent offense. Under center again, wing T version. A handoff quick to number five. Austin Fritch just off to the right side. And a good gain of about a couple more yards there. Actually, a good gain of about 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 yards. Might have the first down, but might be short by a yard.
He's low to less than a yard, I suppose.
That's about 6 yard gain there for Austin Fritch. Number five for the Deckerville Eagles on offense. First series of offense, third down and one. 10:55 to go here in the third of the first quarter, that is. It's third and one. And a handoff again, right up the middle this time. To number 43, Wade Saldana with a big carry for about 3, 4, 5 yards there.
Just doing just what the Bill Brown's done for years. And just lull the defense to sleep and lull them to sleep, and eventually you're going to get that quick pop pass over the top for a big gain.
First down at the 44-yard line. Two backs in the backfield again. Wing T version of 8-player football. Patello under center. And Saldana with a big run to across to about the 49-yard line. A gain of about 7 yards there for Wade Saldana. And it would be second down and about 2 or 3 to go.
The difference between the two backs, Fritch and Saldana. Fritch has the speed, Saldana has all the power. They complement each other well.
That was off to the right. Under 10 to go here in the first quarter. Deckerville driving down the field. Patello gets under center, surveys the defense. Fritch on the right, on the left, Saldana. Saldana gets the handoff. He'll get the first down and rumbles his way to the 45-yard line in Tri-Unity Christian territory. A gain of about 4 yards, it looks like. And he gets the chains moving. It's a first down.
Four quick plays and about 25 yards already for Deckerville. And I mean, that's a good rushing average if you're Bill Brown and this Eagles team.
Driving down the field, it's been their main focus of offense throughout the season. They can pass the ball, though. Patello was the main back last year as a quarterback, but they kind of leaned off on him, but he still has at least over 400, 500-plus yards there. A handoff again, a quick handoff to Saldana as he pushes his way for a gain of about a yard there and make it second down and nine. 9:10 to go here. Second down and nine at about the 44-yard line in Tri-Unity Christian territory for the Eagles. They started at their own 29-yard line.
Tri-Unity with quite the crowd for a 3.5-hour drive up to the middle of nowhere in the thumb. But
yes, they did. They came. That's undefeated season.
Yeah, as expected. State semifinals.
Yes.
A good team.
Fritch with the handoff. He's following his lead blocker there, number 56. To about the 40-yard line almost. It looks like a gain of about 4 yards for Fritch. That was to the left side.
Patello, he didn't pass much this season, 600 yards passing, close to. This game, he might need to really show that arm off.
Deckerville right at the 40-yard line, third down and five, 8:23 to go and counting. We'll try to post a video of this game. later today. And they are going with a power eye formation here.
Got two plays to get this 5 yards.
Man in motion, that is Fritz going to the right side. And a keeper for quarterback Brandon Patel, but he's wrapped up in a loss of about 5-6 yards. Number four with a tackle on Brandon Patel. That is Braden Opoff with a big QB sack and a loss of about 5 yards on that play.
Anytime you get a play for a loss on a drive, it kills you, especially on third down and five. Now I would assume you have to punt the ball after you just tried to pass it and get sacked.
And it's cold in the 40s, and the winds are blowing to the east from the west, almost a little bit, maybe to the north a little bit, but not too much if you look at the flags out there. So it is kind of coming towards Deckerville with this punt.
That would be southwest winds. How about that?
So a good sack there by number four, Opoff, to stymie this, what was a good drive here. This is a huge stop here in the first series.
Ooh, a false start. Pushes by the left end.
Pushes him back even further. Officials getting together. A false start, as Connor said.
Penalties and turnovers this deep in the playoffs will be the determining factor.
Well, the credit goes to the Tri-UD Christian defense poking through. Mm-hmm. That was a different setup there in the I formation. They might have studied some good tape on that, thinking Patello's might maybe may try to keep it there.
Yeah, really good presence by the end to keep him from getting outside of him, keeping that shoulder free, and made the play. Punting from midfield.
Look out for these punt returns. We talked about the pregame show. They have returns for good punt returns. This ball will roll and picked up, but a good tackle there at about the 22-yard line. Not much to return there. Number five could not return that ball. The quarterback, Braden Sherrard, the top offensive play here for Wyoming Tri-UD Christian. He had 6 punt returns, and I'm sure Deckerville knows that. So.
Yeah, a nice tackle there by Austin Fritsch for Deckerville. As soon as he picked the ball up, he was on him. A good punt coverage there, and a pretty decent punt. I mean, with into the wind, and you're getting it down to the 22-yard line, got to make them take up time, too. Even if they score on long drives, your game plan is to make the clock roll. So they spread it out, empty backfield.
That's right, shotgun. Man in motion goes to the left side to the slot. Looking for a pass play. Chased down to the ball is thrown up, and he is sacked with the ball incomplete.
I think that'll be intentional grounding. Yep.
And it is intentional grounding. The flag is thrown. Let's give the credit to number 21 for grabbing the sack. That was James Wangland, the senior, 6-footer, 160 pounds.
And interesting there, Tri-Unity had 3 linemen, and Deckerville sent 4 defensive players. There's no way you can block that. So see if that's their game plan today, is just to get after the quarterback.
You made the point, Connor. Thank you. That's some insight knowledge we had found out. They're going to bring 4 against 3 all day long. That's a mismatch that they're going to look for.
Yeah, make them throw it quick and just trust your athletes on the outside to make a one-on-one tackle.
So it'll be 2nd down and 15. I guess only a 5-yard penalty on that grounding.
So I would assume Deckerville's going to be straight man-to-man on everything when they're rushing 4.
6:39 to go here, 2nd down and 15. Spread formation for Tri-Unity. He'll keep it, and he'll run up the field, and he's finally brought down, getting back to the original line of scrimmage. Might have gained about 6 yards, though. He's 2nd down and 9. Or 3rd down and 9.
Yep.
So got 6 yards back on that one.
Little bunch set left with 3 people and just the jet read option.
That's Braden Sherrard, the quarterback with the keeper, just off the right inside there. 6:13 to go here. 3rd down and 8. I guess he got about 7 on that one. We got a different angle here, so. Spread formation again. Lone back in the back. That is the quarterback. You got a trip set up on the left side. 1 wide receiver on the right side. Looking for a pass play. Incomplete. A trifecta of Eagles there on number 25 to the left side. Nick Wedevin, incomplete.
Quarterback number 5 wanting the roughing the passer call. Didn't get it. Ref talking to him real quick, but they're going to have to punt the ball. And again, that's Eagles defense.
He might be talking to the ref all night long because he's going to have pressure like he hasn't seen yet this season.
I would assume Tri-Unity is going to have to bring one of their receivers back in. And back deep for the Eagles, I believe it's Brandon Patel.
So that's a good stop there defensively for the Eagles. Gets a snap.
Oh, it's a fake.
Fake and complete to number five. He gets the first down on the fake punt. That was the quarterback catching it for the first down on the fake punt.
That's a risky play. It kind of looked like a punt read option. I mean, he caught it like he was going to punt it or throw it. Saw he was open and just dumped it off right at the sticks.
How many yards you got out of eight?
Yeah, I believe so. That was a gutsy call inside your own 30.
Who threw the pass? Number four.
Their punter, yeah.
So Sherrard, you got to give him credit for 9 yards receiving.
But
he can receive, he can punt, return, he can run, he can pass.
Best time to do it early in the game.
Yeah, and especially in your own territory, because if you don't get it, all you do is give Deckerville a short field, and it saves some time.
And he's brought down with a sack. No, he breaks the tackle, Sherrard, but he's got finally brought down with a loss of a yard maybe. We'll see where they mark it.
Austin Spatzel chasing him down.
The fake punt gets into about the 30-yard line, and he might have had a loss of a yard there. Sherrard, minus 1 yard on that play. Deckerville defense flying in and swarming in to stop him there. He's second down about 11. They went for a fake punt, and they got it.
Now, the only thing here with Deckerville's defense mismatching and rushing 4-on-3, you got to be careful that they don't leave the two receivers off the line and have a tight end eligible just for a little dump off. They have nobody in the middle of the field at about 5 yards.
Man in motion again. Sherrard dumps it off, has a receiver with a screen run, number nine, zipping up the middle. He breaks a tackle, and he's going all the way to the right side, finally brought down by number 13, I believe, for the Deckerville Eagles. Out of bounds, and it was number nine with a big catch.
17.
From the 31, I believe, all the way to about
the 30,
34-yard line.
Yeah. So about almost 40 yards there.
I would say, by number nine with a catch. And a big first down into Deckerville territory.
Quick little screen out to the right side of number 12. Drew Claussen picks up about 8 or 9.
Wyatt Janowak able to push out number 9, Benson Heath, who had that big catch.
And these last few plays is what Triuni's going to have to do. They're going to have to get rid of it quick. The big play for 40 yards, they motioned a receiver into the backfield to throw an extra blocker in.
Second down in 3 now. A 7-yard catch by Claussen. Number 12 with that catch, receiving-wise. And down the line of scrimmage, an incomplete to number 9, Heath, on the left side. 4:26 to go here in Shrine Unity Christian in Deckerville territory. This is the farthest either team has gotten on each other, and this is the first series still for Tri-UD Christian. And they went for a fake punt at fourth down 11 and completed it. Here they are at the 27-yard line. Be third down and 3. 4 down territory at this point.
That surprise fake punt, probably one of the first ones they've done all season. Didn't really need to with their 11-0 record. Probably not down very much.
4:26. Here's the high potent offense. They have many weapons. We knew about the speedy weapons they had. Spread offense again. Man in motion. He'll keep it. Trying to break for the 3 yards. He'll be brought down with a sack. Austin French able to break the backfield, bringing down the quarterback, Sherrard. And a loss of about 2 yards will be fourth down and about 5.
See what they do here. Not having a lot of time to go down the field, they're going to have to get it quick and see if they can have a play on the outside with their athletes.
Probably a loss of 3, actually.
Right down about 4th and 5 now.
Under 4 to go here in the first quarter. No score, 0-0. This is the first series of offense for Tri-Unity Christian. Deckerville had one, too. They had the punt. Tri-Unity was going to punt at 4th down 11 from the 20-something yard line. Here they are. Split wide receivers, double set, left and right. Looking for a pass play. We'll throw it up. And way over the head, incomplete on 4th down and 6. And Deckerville showing some sportsmanship. We're using a little bit of psychology.
Mind games.
There.
I'm going to hit you hard, but I'm going to help you up even if you don't want it. And it looked like a little miscommunication there. The receiver outside tried to fight over to the inside of the corner, and quarterback threw it just deep.
So Deckerville takes over on downs. It'll be first down and 10 from their own 30-yard line.
Let's make sure we keep adding this throughout the broadcast. A young team for Wyoming Tri-Unity Christian. Mostly freshman starters and sophomores. Just three senior starters and one junior.
Yeah, you could look for them to be back again next year.
Yes, sir.
Running the ball.
There he goes.
Look
number five.
All the way. He is all the way to Port Huron for the touchdown for 70 yards. Austin Fritsch. Deckerville leading 6-0 at the 3:22 mark.
That was a quick score.
That's not what Deckerville tries to do, but they're going to take scores anytime you can get them. Looked like just a straight dive handoff. And this is where eight-man football is won, on these conversions, because anybody's going to score a touchdown here and there, but it's these conversions. I mean, you look at last night at the Division I level for high school football. Detroit Cass Tech beat Saline 43-42. They were down by seven on their last drive and scored and went for two and got it. And it's those conversions that win and lose games.
70-yard touchdown run by Austin Fritsch in the first play. Two-point conversion good by Brandon Patello, who's been doing the bulk of the two-point conversions. It is 8-0, Deckerville leading, 3:22 to go here. Deckerville leading Tri-Unity Christian. 8-0 in the first quarter. 70-yard touchdown run by Austin Fritsch. You listen to Thump Chunk of Sports. Game being brought to you by Kohler Oil Propane. And our webcast being powered by SpeakConnect.com.
Some people take to it easier than others, but everyone can benefit from a little help in the search for their health. That helping hand comes from the Health Store in Sandusky. At the Health Store, all the vitamins and minerals you and your family need are available. The linchpin to healthy living is healthy eating. And at the Health Store, the variety of natural foods such as wheat, gluten-free foods, and more can make all the difference. The Health Store in Sandusky is open Monday through Thursday, 9:30 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. Fridays, 9:30 to 6, and Saturdays, 10 to 2.
Come back. Welcome back after the Deckerville touchdown. You said the score 22-0. I can't see the scoreboard from
where I'm saying. It is 22-0.
How many minutes before halftime? I can't even
see.
3:45 to go here.
3:45 before halftime. Deckerville with a solid lead in themselves.
And remember, Tri-Unity will get the ball to start the second half. So if you can score here late in the half, you know, it's a totally different ball game.
Yes,
totally different ball game.
Momentum with them at halftime to get the ball in the second half.
Make some halftime adjustments. I'd assume they have to adjust their protection on the line.
It's already halftime on WLW Sports Network. It is New Lothrop leading Ubley 13-6.
Close game over there.
Ubley had a chance. I think Ubley has a chance. Stronger defense this year. They beat the best team in the Greater Thumb Conference. Who's in the running for team of the year? Millington or Ubley, you think? Huh?
I don't know.
Look at that kickoff of a touchback with the win into the end zone, and Tri-Unity Christian will start at their own 20-yard line. What a booming kick there.
So what you got to do, especially here late with the clock in your favor, is with Deckerville's defense. Make them go 80 yards in less than 4 minutes. See if they can.
Jackson Lumen Christie right now in action against Napoleon. We talked about that last night. They're leading 28-0 in that game. Tied at 14, Frankenmuth in Ithaca.
Ithaca's good. I just don't know if they're Division 5 good.
Division 5, I think, was the most wide-open division coming in. That or 6. I mean, I go through, like, bracketology in March and see if I can pick the games in the winter.
Big shout-out to David Baselock. He's listening to the game in Wadhams. My best friend, Dave. Big shout out to you and a former Deckerville defensive coach and player also here from Deckerville High School. A big shout out to David Baselock and Rhonda Wallace out there. in Wadhams, near Port Huron, where we actually took the road all the way through. So
I was just in Wadhams last night.
So were we.
On my way up from Oakland University, I stayed at my grandparents' house in great old Port Sanilac today.
Oh, my hometown.
Yeah, the for can't now. Beat it there.
No gain there, by the way, for Sherrard, for Tri-Duty Christian.
I should say my current hometown, being from Sandusky, but living out in Port Sanilac now.
Well, you picked a better town. Now, I would say.
I got the lake, the beautiful water.
Big rivals with Sandusky.
Yes.
Can't say I love that town.
Spread
some
formation.
Influence on me, though.
Split wide receiver, Sherrard. In the shotgun position. Hard count. He gets a snap. Looking down the field. A short pass and cup on number 12. Positive yards for about 4 yards. Wraparound tackle by number 9, I do believe, Brandon Botello. Number 12 catching that catch. That was Drew Clausen. Gain of about 4 yards.
Thank you,
Connor.
Third
down and six with 2.5 to go
here. Thank you, Connor, for bringing up some old football memories for me. My days against Marlette, I'll bring it up. I've said it before on air, but since I got a Marlette alumni right here, my 2 years on varsity, Marlette never scored a point against us, 99-0.
Well, you know, we don't have the proud tradition like Deckerville does. We do have one of the state's longest losing streaks. Consecutive losses in a row.
Left side trip set up here in spread formation for Tri-Duty Christian. 22-0, Deckerville leading in the second quarter with 2 minutes to go. A high pass, lofting it in, and a push off, and he catches it. Number 4 with the catch and a flag thrown in at the end of that play there.
I think they're going to get him for pass interference.
He kind of pushed off there.
I don't think the Deckerville defender located the ball. He was running with his hands up in his face.
And didn't that, even that turn big, back, did he?
That big thing mm-hmm. now that you hear is locating and finding the ball.
All pass interference on Deckerville.
And I don't believe they'll accept it. I think they'll just take the catch where it is.
Braden Opoff with the big catch down to about the 46-yard line.
They
22-yard
do.
Catch for the big first down to the right side of the field. By number 4, Braden Opoff with the catch.
Tri-Unity getting some plays going, even though that wasn't the best of passes.
Chasing down Sherrard, the quarterback, and he slips away. Pushed out of bounds, almost tripping over the practice football on the side of the field of Tri-Unity Christian, and he gained a yard on that hard play there, breaking the tackles and avoiding the sack.
That He's play, got some speed, doesn't
that
he?
That play reminds me of a play back when I was here.
Yeah.
We had a player, number 4, Anthony Kappen, actually get flipped over the fence.
Mm.
I do believe now that the sideline is in more, not an issue, but when the 11-player lines are out, actually flipped over the fence on that side. Funny for us now that he's okay afterwards.
That would be scary.
But, yeah, I wouldn't want to be the one flipping over it. Second and 9.
Is that a 27-yard catch or an 18? That last play, huh? And a pass and incomplete. Intended for number 4, Opoff, who caught the last first down. And Patillo asking him to help up, and he avoids wanting to be helped up by Deckerville.
He got helped up by his own team there, and, you know, it is what it is. Nice play there by Patello.
I feel bad. I want to add some more stuff about our Redskins.
That was a 17-yard catch, right?
About seven.
Yeah.
Okay. Our Redskin Red Raider rivalry. That was when I played pre-Coach Denny Lester, pre-spread offense. Marlette, they've come a long ways. Quite proud of what I see out of them now.
Yes. Thank you for that. I mean.
Yes, it is something
definitely
different.
Definitely different. Turning the tide around with a new offense.
Third down and 9. Did stop the clock with an incomplete pass with 1:42 to go here in the second quarter. Chase down. He breaks a tackle game. Goes up the middle. Has a lead block. 10 yards by Sherrard. And more for the first down as he runs out of bounds and stops the clock. A good gain there from the 46-yard line.
Tri-Unity's got
to
be careful.
Territory.
They're a little peel back block. I mean, it was in the play a little bit. One of those iffy, do you call it, do you not?
I mean, borderline.
From up here, I think I call it just because you want those hits out of the game.
Mm-hmm.
The unnecessary. It's one thing to stand in his way, but then to lower your shoulder into the guy, regardless if you mean to or not, you're still doing it.
In the NFL, they're calling that defenseless player.
A 14-yard broken play carry there by the quarterback keeper. Trips it up on the left side. Gets the handoff. He fakes it. Spin move by Sherrard. He breaks a tackle. Stiff arm. And he's pushed out of bounds for a gain of a couple yards to the right side in Deckerville's side of the field.
I'm impressed with this kid, number five, Sherrard. Putting the team on his back. He's getting four guys in on him, and he's finding a way to get through them and make it zero or a positive game.
He got 3 yards, and there will be second down and seven, 1:24 to go here, and him going out of bounds stops the clock again. They have, what, spent two timeouts? Did they spend
Yeah, they only have one left. How much time's on the clock?
They got 1:24 to go here in the second quarter. Tri-Unity Christian leading down the field on the back of the leading offensive player, the quarterback, number five, Braden Sherrard.
Look for Tri-Unity to go to the middle of the field here. Nobody's in the middle of the field.
Split wide receivers going up the middle. Sack, and he misses. The sack, a flag is thrown in. He'll throw up the pass, incomplete. Sherrard being chased down. And number 81 almost had him, but Sherrard able to shake him off. That was number 81, Austin Spatzel.
He got away from the arms, the big hands of Spatzel. Sherrard just dips his shoulder and kind of moves him off to the side.
I believe it's going to be a hold call. We'll see what they do call. It's in the area of holding.
1:16 to go here. Number nine had that block. As he went in motion, he stayed for the block to protect the quarterback. That was number nine for Tri-Unity Christian, Benson Heath. 1:16 to go here, 22-0, Deckerville leading Tri-Unity Christian. He'll be a holding, defensive holding on Deckerville, holding on Tri-Unity Christian. They offset, and it'll be second down and seven here, but it'll be third down maybe, right?
It's interesting. I don't think I've ever seen a defensive penalty. Holding call. That's tough. I mean, from inside the tackles, you know?
Defensive holding.
And it's going to be an offensive hold as well, so it's going to offset, and you're going to replay the down.
Okay, so it's second down and seven, 1:16 to go here.
I believe the ref was explaining it. The defender grabbed the offensive lineman and threw him down. Rather than just pushing him down, he threw him down, and that's where that defensive hold comes in.
Ball at the 38-yard line.
Second and about seven and a half.
Split wide receivers, gets a snapshot of position. Down the line of scrimmage, caught by number nine, Heath. Heath, positive yards, a gain of about 6 yards. He'll be short by a yard. He'll be third down in about a yard.
They got to get on the ball here.
Yeah, that was inbound tackle. They do have a timeout, I think.
At number nine, they don't give the height, but he's got to be not anywhere close to 6 foot. Little quick guy, though.
And just a sophomore.
Yeah, he really does look like a sophomore out there. Probably about 5'9".
7 yard catch, third down and two. For third down and two, caught in the slot by number four. He breaks a tackle on a huge gain there.
That's
from the 32-yard line, and they'll quickly get to the line of scrimmage with 37 seconds to go here.
Clock will stop till the chains get set.
Ball at the 16-yard line, so a gain of about 10 yards.
That was Braden Opoff.
Incomplete.
Miscommunication.
31 seconds to go there. That's to the left side. Incomplete. First down and 10 will be second down.
And not only miscommunication there, but you could really see how rushed Sherrard is in the pocket. I mean, not letting that out route develop because he thinks he's going to get hit within a second and a half. So he's catching it, and he's firing already, not letting the out route get there.
16-yard reception there for that first down for number four, Opoff.
And that out route is already a fast route to develop.
Five in a line, trips it up on the right side. Sherrard breaks a tackle. He'll toss it up. And intercepted with a one-handed interception in the end zone or at the one-yard line. What a catch intended for Opoff in the end zone and leaping up and grabbing it with one hand. Number nine, Brandon Patello.
Wow.
Did he fall at the one-yard line or into the end zone?
I think he's at the one-yard line. That is a heck of a play by your senior quarterback, Brandon Patello. One of the best picks I've seen all year. Heck of a play. And now I think they're just going to knee it and take it to the half.
It'll be 22-0. Deckerville leading Tri-Unity Christian to end the quarter. Where they try to do an onside, but caught by Tri-Unity Christian at the 40-yard line with a return of about 2 yards here. And they'll start off on offense as he elected to defer to Deckerville, number 25, for the return for a couple yards, Nick Wedevin.
Shout out to Carly Shagney, graduated from Deckerville. She goes to Oakland University.
That's right. That's Doug's.
That is Doug
daughter.
Shagney's daughter. They've moved
Chugger.
To Port Sanilac. Yep, Chugger.
And that,
they are listening.
That is
Chugger.
Patello's.
That is Tyler Patello's girlfriend.
Still.
Okay. They've been going for quite a long time. I believe he said 6 years the other day, way back from high school. I saw Tyler and Dylan at halftime. She's calling me out on Twitter for recruiting to Oakland during halftime. Maybe Oakland's listening too and they can give me a tuition discount.
There you go.
Trip set up on the right side. It'll be a handoff though to number 9. A quick handoff and a tackle. Some great positive yards from the 42-yard line to about the 49. A gain of 7 yards for number 9 to the right side, Benson Heath. To start off the second half.
We said that these young guys, these underclassmen, will get all the playing time they can handle, and they sure do.
Ball at the 49-yard line for Tri-Unity Christian, their own 49-yard line.
Good positive play there for Tri-Unity. See, they've had to have made adjustments at halftime.
Man in motion again. Heath, fake handoff, a nice pass, and caught by number 10 for the first down. Push tackle there, number 10 with the catch. Down to about the 45-yard line, a catch of about 6 yards there for number 10, Bennett Sinner, his first catch.
Another sophomore also getting plenty of playing time. And that would be number 13, Janowick, with the touchdown-saving tackle. He was the only guy back.
Gets the first down also. 224 yards total rushing for Deckerville in the first half. Under 11 to go here. First down and 10 at the 45-yard line. Tri-Unity Christian already in Deckerville territory. You cannot rest in your laurels here, Mikey.
Not at all. This is deep in the playoffs.
And you know Tri-Unity has the high-powered offense. They can come back. Ooh, a double reverse.
Heath with it now, and a tackle on the grab on the leg there by Deckerville's number 56 with the tackle. That is Reese Bass Kramer, the senior, longtime player along with Austin Spatzel on this Deckerville team.
Yes, they've been around a long time in this system. Really do a nice job defensively, not falling for the jet sweep and staying home on their assignment for the reverse back.
10-18 to go here in the third quarter as we start the second half. Ball at about the 44-yard line. A gain of 2 yards on that last play on that carry. For number 12, was that carry at last? Slipped away with a sack attempted. Sherrard breaks another tackle, runs out of bounds with positive yards.
You might get a late hit out of bounds flag. Yeah, they're going to throw it.
Add some more yards to that one.
Yeah, I agree with that call. You have to let up as soon as you hit the sideline. I know it's tough for the defensive player, but you know, you just gotta be aware of your surroundings and the sideline and know when that player's going out of bounds.
He can see
and let up.
He can see that guy if he's one step out of bounds or heading 2 bounds.
Now it's one thing if you come up and you act like you're gonna hit him but just wrap him up and hold him. Yep. But he finished through the tackle and that's gonna get 15 yards every time.
Would have been 3rd and 4 or 5, and now it's a first down. 9:53 to go here. Deckerville leading 22-0, and Tri-Unity Christian again driving down the field. Now the last play that they had offensively was an interception in the end zone. Brandon Patello with an athletic one-handed grab for the INT to take the knee. And Wyoming Tri-Unity Christian now at the Deckerville 25-yard line in third quarter. Split wide receivers, man in motion to the left side. Looking for a pass play, reverse play to Sherrard. He catches it to the 20-yard line. It was a handoff from Sherrard to number 12 who passed it. That was Drew Clausen, and Sherrard catches it for 5 yards.
I think we're going to see an offensive creativity this second half.
So do I, and I mean, credit so far to Deckerville. They've seen a couple wrinkles in the offense, some trick plays, and they're sticking to their own assignments and not falling for the tricks.
Staying home.
Yeah.
That is a third thrower for Wyoming Trinity Christian.
Here. And, you know, you look at some of these passes by Tri-Unity, they're not anything fancy. They're not Matt Stafford-like sidearm slinging that thing in there. They're lofting them up, and really almost every pass that Tri-Unity's thrown has an opportunity to be picked.
Incomplete.
That one again, an opportunity to be picked.
Second down and five there. Now it's third down and five with 9 minutes to go. Stops the clock. Ball at the 20-yard line at the red zone is Tri-Unity Christian.
This is a big play here for Tri-Unity. Look for him to take two plays, so you could see a run here. Just opportunity to where you can run or pass for the first down on fourth down.
Video of this game will be posted later, today or tomorrow. Live webcast, audio-wise, will be available after the conclusion of our coverage. And throwing it up and out of reach with the interception attempt to the left corner. Number 13 was there, but a long overhead pass be fourth down and five after the incomplete pass by Sherrard.
Miscommunication there, again, by the defenders from Tri-Unity. They can't be on the same page offensively with the receivers to their quarterback. And it showed there, that guy throws it up to the pylon and nobody's even 10 yards within the...
That's what I was looking at. I didn't see nobody there.
Closest person there was Deckerville's own defender.
Mm-hmm.
Fourth down and five. They obviously go for it. You're in the red zone here. Third quarter here. Second half, Deckerville leading 22-0.
This is a big play here for Tri-Unity. You've moved the ball down the field. They're going to take a timeout.
Hmm. 8:54 to go here. Fourth down and five. Timeout called here by the Deckerville Eagles. Tri-Unity, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, Tri-Unity timeout, fourth and five. Want to give a quick shout-out to a Marlette Red Raider himself, Sean Quady, sophomore
at
Marlette.
Hey, I remember that name.
He's listening in.
From basketball.
He starts basketball on Monday.
Really?
Looking for a big season out of him and the Red Raiders. You know, just a lot of people coming back. Obviously, they lose Storm, but they have a lot coming back. Young talent that played with me when I was a senior as sophomores.
Uh-huh.
So they're going to have a very experienced team this year, trickled in with Sean Quady, the sophomore, and Bryce George, the freshman. I'm not 100% if he'll be up or down, but this kid was dunking in eighth grade last year.
Yeah, former Marlette player Brad Schaub doing a fantastic job at Northwood right now.
Yep.
And I saw that game against another former Thumb area player from Emily City in that Michigan State and Northwood game. Fantastic.
Northwood
to
played
see.
Well.
And incomplete. He did not turn his head. And Sherrod is upset with his team. A turnover and downs and a flag on that.
You might get a unsportsmanlike conduct on number five.
Unsportsmanlike on who? Deckerville or Tri-Unity?
A Tri-Unity, maybe.
And no, it's on Tri-Unity.
It's going to be a first down Deckerville, and it's going to be an unsportsmanlike on Deckerville.
Mm-hmm.
So Deckerville will have the ball.
Okay.
Half the distance back to the goal.
What was there some colorful words being used?
I think so.
You know what? And this is the undiscipline you cannot have when you're this far in the playoffs.
You can't.
Dan Brown, the defensive coach, went right out there and pointed his finger, and that kid is going to be doing some laps and up-downs come Monday.
I wouldn't want to be him.
Actually,
he's going to do it before he gets to the locker room.
Get to the locker room today, yeah.
He's going to have to run all the way across the dirt field to that little hunting blind that I see off in the distance and back before he's allowed back in the locker room.
Look at that stick out. It's white.
Nothing like farm country up here in the Thumb. Got some windmills off to the north. I don't know if we can see them now.
Deckerville will start their own 10-yard line. And a carry there by Austin Fritz. He breaks a tackle for about 6-5 yards there to the left side. 8:43 to go here in the third quarter. Deckerville leading 22-0. And a gain of about 5 or 6 yards there for Austin Fritz.
So, no running clock here in the second half. For Deckerville, our first game this year that we've done that.
Oh, really?
We've had running clocks a lot.
This is our sixth game?
Fifth or sixth.
Okay. Covering Deckerville. Under center, Patello, wing T version. And
false start
offsides on Deckerville, number 56, Reese Bass Kramer.
They're going to talk about it.
Ball.
Looked like an obvious false start, but I don't know. Maybe somebody was saying something on the on Tri-Unity side.
.8:14 to go here. Deckerville leading 22-0. A flag was thrown. I thought it might have been a false start or offsides on Deckerville. The officials are talking it over right now. Five officials here, right? Yeah.
Yes, five officials. I believe they're from the thumb, which is a good sign. I mean, as you get later in the tournament.
Shorter drive for your officials?
Yes, you're going to get the cream of the crop. And to have, I believe I had some of these in high school myself.
How do they decide the state championship?
So we're so you get rated by the coaches after the game. And then it's obviously your experience and all that. And just the higher rated officials will be going longer in the season.
Same as the NFL, though.
Yep, same as the NFL, same as basketball. Anything, any sport in the MHSAA, officials are based off of ratings for the tournament.
So a five-yard penalty on Decker, but they get to the 15-yard line with a carry by Austin Fritsch, gets those yards back. A third down in about five here.
And unlike the regular season where schools are responsible for getting their own officials, the MHSAA takes control of all the officials for the tournament and selects them themselves. Mark Ewell, a very good guy at the MHSAA, head of officials. He will umpire College World Series, Big Ten baseball games. He actually, I don't know if you remember, in the College World Series was the second base umpire that got hit with a line drive.
Ball at the 15-yard line and a broken tackle. Austin Fritsch off to the races. See you later. He's off the roof for the touchdown. Deckerville. 85-yard touchdown run. Austin Fritsch from the left side. His fourth touchdown with 7:19 to go here in the third quarter. 28-0.
Another run by Fritsch. That's going to be his 19th carry for 266 yards, 14-yard average. Wow.
There we go. And how many carries?
I think 19 carries.
19 carries.
He made it all the way to Harbor Beach on that run, too.
I don't know about that. That's a little bit farther.
How about he just stop when he got in the end zone?
He might have had the cabbage or Polish sausage.
He made it up. He made it up to Verona Hills, but not quite to Harbor Beach. Stopping off for a quick bite to eat at the golf course.
Patello will keep it into the end zone for the 2 points.
30-0, Deckerville leading Tri-Unity Christian in the third quarter. 7:19 to go here. You're listening to Thumb Tailgater Sports. Boy, will you ever.
Yeah. So you're fired as a cameraman. Yeah, that's fine. I'll go back to call my own games.
You'll have to get Bubba on crew, and he can film for you.
That'll work.
He'll bring you popcorn and water, too, all night long.
Bubba? I like that.
Roy Bubba Armstrong, Marlette's finest. I'm surprised he didn't find a ride here with one of the officials. He usually finds a way to get all of these games.
Mm-hmm.
And if he was here, we would see, because he would be the ball boy out there on the field.
Now, he was there back in my days against Marlette.
He's been around a long time. He still has not come to a state final game. Mm. Probably a good thing. He might be kicked out and banned from the tournament if he did, because he'd be all over the place.
Right.
My fondest memory of Bubba was when Brad Schaub dunked the ball over at the All-Star game, leaping over his head and just grazing his melon.
Yeah. Bubba didn't know what to expect,
and Brad wanted to do it again, because did he miss?
Yeah, he missed.
He wanted to do it again, and Bubba walked right off that
court. He was doing his little running jog off the court before Brad could do it again, but definitely a fun night at that All-Star game, as it is every year.
And at the end of the third quarter, New Lothrop still leading 13-6 against Ubley, but they got a huge first down and fourth and two by Mychek, right?
Yes, Mychek.
Ubley is driving at the end of the third quarter here. It's 30-0 in the third quarter, 7:19 to go, and a kickoff return here to the 35-yard line for Trinity Christian. Go ahead.
I was just pointing out the Twitter, Colin tweeted out on Twitter. I'm not sure why his middle name is Bagel, but if he doesn't have any Einstein bagels for us, he might as well get out of the press box.
Incomplete pass there from Brady Sherrod. Sherrod, right?
Okay. Sherrod, yes. Sherrod.
The leading offensive player here, trying to keep Tri-Uni Christian and trying to find a way to get them in the end zone here. They were driving down the field again in the red zone twice.
New quarterback in here for Tri-Unity. They split Sherrod out to the right. Watch for this double pass.
That is number four.
Brandon. False start. That's what they were going to do.
Opoff. That's Braden Opoff. And by the way, they're the Heath kids, Efren Heath and also Benson Heath in the game, are the sons of the head coach, Tim Heath, the assistant head coach, Don Sherrod, the father of Braden Sherrod of Tri-Unity Christian. The Defenders is the mascot name.
And in a co-op with the Calvary Schools of Holland.
Are they?
Yes, they are. I believe I was listening on the radio on my way here with my grandpa to WMIC, John Presnell and Cliff Amy next door. They said that Tri-Unity started 1 year in eight-man back in 2010, I believe, then switched to 11-man in a co-op, and now they're back here. I believe they started last year as eight-man. But in the co-op, I'm not sure who they co-opted with, but in co-op 11-man, their record was 6-30.
Ooh. Powers North Central are the defending state eight-player champions from last year. They are moving on after defeating Pickford, and boy, their stats are nuts. 2,715 yards rushing for Powers North Central. Passing-wise, 2,694 yards passing. That's some crazy eight-player football. Shotgun position, trips it up on the right side. Throwing it up down the middle of the field. Almost intercepted and breaking his hand, stopping the ground number 56.
Reese Bays Kramer.
He's going to wish he didn't do that.
It's cold out here the last couple days.
Breaks a finger and can't play.
And he's looking at his hand. He thinks, I think I sprained it. Incomplete there pass attempted by Braden Opoff down the middle of the field and could have been into the hands of Reese Bays Kramer for maybe a gain of 2 yards. He's a big guy.
He did. He had the ball in his hands, just couldn't hold on to the interception.
He looked like he was a defensive lineman on that pick.
He did. He was bummed.
7:10 to go here. 30-0, Deckerville leading.
Big third down and 10.
Split wide receiver on left and right. Man in motion. Sherrod back in quarterback. A gain of only about a yard there on that play.
Kramer Patello in on the tackle. Also, the senior Jonathan Ridley. He gets quite a bit of action on the defensive side of the ball.
Fourth down and 9, and they'll have to punt it off unless they go for it. It looks like they will be punted off. Number 4 there, Braden Opoff, to punt it off for Tri-Unity Christian Defenders. Punt into the wind. It will roll past the 40 to about the 42-yard line is where Deckerville will take over on their own 42-yard line, Mikey. 6:27 to go here. It is 30-0.
Getting creeping towards that running clock. I'm surprised by this. We know that the Tri-Unity offense is unstoppable all season long, but they ran into the juggernaut of the Eagle defense.
I have not seen one pass play here by Deckerville.
Nothing.
And you talked about the winner of this game getting Powers North Central.
Yeah.
Well, I believe last year was Powers North Central first
yes.
year
yes,
in
was.
The eight-man football.
Yes.
They are on a current 25-game win streak in eight-man football. Yes. Undefeated in their 2 years.
Yep.
They are definitely the powerhouse of eight-man.
This is nuts on how many yards they have. 5,500-plus yards total offense. That's ridiculous.
Looking at the Michigan football website online, that's a very nice website for Michigan High School football. They are currently points for, 747 as of last week, not last night's game.
We had a two-yard gain by...
And the inside, I think it would have been... see, Patel was back out there. Yeah, for the Eagles. Yep, that was Patel on the inside.
Chase or Brandon?
I'm sorry. Saldana.
Wait, Saldana. Yeah, he's back in the game after being out since a late second
yes.
quarter. So.
You say again, throw those numbers out there again, Connor.
Second down and eight at the 40-yard line for Deckerville. I formation, Patello under center, man in motion. To the left side, a straight up the middle handoff here for Deckerville for a couple of yards. That is number 43, Wade Saldana.
So last night, I believe Powers North Central scored 62 points, bringing their season total to 809.
Wow.
Allowing only 226. Not as strong as last year, where they were 915 for and 166 allowed.
Not too shabby, though, with over 800.
Hey, I'd take it, too.
With another game to go.
Yes, one more game to go. Definitely the powerhouse.
Definitely the most favored to win the state championship.
Yeah, I picked them myself. Sorry, Deckerville. You can't argue with a 25-game win streak. But prove me wrong. I hope Deckerville will prove me wrong next week, assuming they hold on to this game.
Oh, boy, they take too much time here. Got a waste of timeout with under 5 minutes to go. Third down and six. Timeout called by Deckerville. They lead 30-0 against Trinity Unity Christian. You're listening to Thumb Tugger Sports. Eddie Fury here along with Connor Thomas. Mike Smith, a Thumb Tugger Sports crew here. A big shout-out to Phil Nickel. A fake handoff and a keeper by Brandon Patello. He breaks a tackle down from the 50 all the way to Parisville for the touchdown. Touchdown run on third down and six. Quarterback Brandon Patello. No, not Austin Fritch.
No, that's why we call him Big Play Brandon.
Big Play Patello.
Big Play.
Even
big
though
play
Chase Patello. Is out here, he'll follow in the footsteps next year as a senior.
Yep.
58-yard touchdown run. He had a double quick handoff there. Kept it.
That's the same play that Connor and I just talked about here in the second quarter.
That is only his fourth carry of the game.
But it's a big one.
That brings his average up a lot.
Going for two here, obviously. We'll get his own two-point conversion.
I guarantee it's a... Oh, they're a power eye now. But same concept.
Hanley's going to have the ball, but he's not going to be in.
But damage has been done. 36-0. Deckerville leading in the third quarter. Coming out of the timeout on third down and six. 4:41 to go here. You're listening to Thumb Tailgater Sports.
Some of the little kids are playing some football. Maybe they want to put them in some shoulder pads and get them on the field.
Looks like we have a scoring update. Frank can move. Ithaca. Turnover and downs. Aubley will take over at midfield. And they're having that lead right now against New Lothrop.
Look like they can just sit on the ball. Just like Ubley does every year.
Frankenmuth leading 28-17 against Ithaca. Well, that would be a huge upset there.
And if Ubley does pull off the win, that would be our first two
11-man teams. 4.5 minutes to go right now for Ubley against New Lothrop. That will be an upset.
Because we have not had yet two of our coverage teams in the semifinal.
And it is 14-13, you said, correct?
When I last checked, yes.
Again, it's those extra points.
Yes.
Extra points win in the playoffs.
14-13 Ubley leading, and they have recovered a fumble. And we could have Frankenmuth, Ubley, Algonac, Deckerville, Millington, five of our coverage area teams
here
into
we go.
The next round.
The winner of that
first
game.
Down and 10.
The winner of Ubley New Lothrop will play.
Caught by number nine at the 10-yard line. A gain of about 10 yards by number nine. That is Benson Heath.
That's the scary north side of that.
Yeah, Traverse City St. Francis hosting Pawama Westphalia today. That game, I thought at the start of the playoffs, would be for the state championship.
Yes. Yep.
So if Ubley can hang on, they're going to have their hands full. But, you know, making it this far, that's got to be good for their program, good for their community as a whole.
Second down and two. I think that there was a penalty on Tri-Unity Christian. That's why they were pushed back to the 15-yard line, I believe, or 10-yard line. A pass and an open field tackle as helped up Brandon Botello, helping up number 12 who caught the pass. That was Drew Clawson with the catch.
So either whoever wins, Ubley or New Lothian, they're going to have their hands absolutely full.
Just a yard reception on that catch. Coming down to 10 seconds in the third quarter. Deckerville leading 36-0. They have a running clock there as we head to the fourth quarter. And maybe we went on to the next round. I'm not going to count my chickens.
No. I'll call a game sooner than you.
And real quick here, Frankenmuth, if they hold on to beat Ithaca, they also will get Menominee or Reed City.
Another tough, that north side of those divisions.
Final quarter coming up in the fourth. It is Deckerville leading 36-0 against Tri-Unity Christian for the MHSAA South Division 8-players state semifinal game. It's Eddie Fury with you, along with Connor Thomas, Mike Smith, and in spirit, Phil Nickel.
Also in spirit, then Mickey and Adam, too.
Mickey Strickler, yes. He is hard at work at the health store right now in Sandusky. Stop by and pick up your energy drinks, honey, vitamins, supplements, or a massage by the nice ladies or guy.
Yes, there you go.
Strong hands, man. Those Russians.
As I said earlier, boys basketball in the state of Michigan starting practice on Monday. And then hunting also starts on Tuesday, opening day.
Third down and two for Tri-Duty Christian. Sherrard breaks a tackle, moving ahead, gets the first down, down the middle of the field. From the 23-yard line, brought down at about the 37-yard line.
Connor mentioned the basketball season. Look for Phil and I to be covering Friday night basketball in high school level.
14-yard gain there by Braden Sherrard.
I'm hoping I can get up to a few, cover some games. I know I've picked up some JV games to officiate over Christmas break.
11 and a half to go here in the fourth quarter. Sherrard gets the snap in the shotgun position. Will throw it up incomplete, out of bounds. Split wide receivers. The clock will continue to run. It is 36-0. Deckerville leading. Again, you were saying?
Yeah, hopefully I can get up some and help you call some basketball games.
Of course.
I already talked to Yale's Kate Spesnick. The other day I saw him in Saginaw, the MHSAA Sportsmanship Summit. Yep. Of course, he's on the Student Advisory Council like I was. I talked to him and Andy Freshour from the MHSAA and talked about how he went off when I called his games last year.
A little inside joke to Kate Smeg's neck. You can throw interceptions in basketball.
Yes, you can.
Threw a lot in football.
Yeah.
That's an inside joke. And a big tackle to the backfield, number 28 on number 9. Heath, as that was the reverse handoff there.
It was reverse handoff. Jonathan Ridley staying home at his defensive end spot and just creaming, crushing him.
And a loss of 8 yards on that play. I believe it was a loss of 8 yards, right? I thought we had a first down earlier.
An incomplete pass.
Oh, that's
and
right.
And then that sack.
Okay,
yep.
There you go.
Kind of nice being up here in the press box out of the wind. Luckily, my grandma's at home making some chili for dinner.
I had that not too long ago, and my wife made some chicken and rice. Last night, we went to the border in Wadhams, and I had those new rolled tacos with guacamole. Delicious. Down the field, Sherrard being chased down. He'll throw it up, an incomplete pass in the slot on the right side, intended for number 7, that was Brandon Pinder. 9:35 to go and counting. It'll be fourth down situation for Tri-Unity Christian.
Big fourth down coming up.
Fourth down, I would assume they're gonna punt it just because don't make a bad game worse, but we'll see what they do.
Very deep in their own territory.
Yeah.
Fourth down a long, long ways. Let's see if I can see the scoreboard. I can't.
I'll peek out there. It's 9 minutes left on the clock. 36-18.
They're going to punt it away. Kicking from his own 22-yard
line. Nobody down
line.
There. Nope. I think Bill Brown wanted to play it safe.
Let the ball roll down. It's going to roll down and stop at the 25-yard line.
Good crowd today for Deckerville, obviously. Anytime you get a state semifinal at in the home. Thumb, you get people not only from Deckerville,
right.
yep. but, I mean, people from Peck, Port Sanilac. You get the whole county. It's really it really is a great place to grow up and have some high school football just because when you do make those runs, you get so much support from everybody around here. And I'm sure there's some Huron County teams that made the trip down to watch.
My uncle has no kids at all involved in football, and he comes to either Sandusky or Deckerville football game
yeah.
every weekend.
And, I mean, you even got Lawrence people here. Yeah. You got all the alumni from past Bill Brown teams. A really good football support program.
Wait till you see how many shows up for the finals if they do make it. Get a little chippy down there on the field, but let's see if they straighten that mess out.
And I wouldn't be surprised here if Bill Brown starts putting in his backups just because of that reason. You don't want anybody making a dumb decision getting kicked out of this
right,
game because
right.
then you're gone for your state final game. And because, you have them at your disposal. So you might as well use them if you can.
Looks
Who
like
was
Eddie's
the ball carrier on
I didn't
that?
See it. We'll make up a number. Eddie wants to hear you to do stats. I got away from stats now from Eddie.
We'll get in my Lawrence friend here from Oakland. Colin, I can't pronounce your last name. But just go in here. We'll give that carry to Patello for 3 yards or 5-6 yards.
I'll do it for you guys, too. Patello handoff. It's going to be up on the inside going for the first down a little bit more. That will be number.
So pick up about 5 or 4 there.
Yep, do 5 on that number 43. That'll
for
be
number 43, Saldana, picking up about 4 yards.
And they'll be all unofficial, so if we get them close, that's cool. Fresh set of downs for the Eagles. The ball now sits at the 38-yard line. Still the Eagles' side of the field. That's the 38-yard line for the Eagles. Still most all the starters in the game. Kind of surprised by that.
Yeah.
Just late in the game with the
I
running
am
clock.
Too. You don't want to risk any injury.
No injuries, no.
But you know.
No fumbles, yes.
Bill Brown's got to figure it out. I'm not going to argue the way he thinks because
nope.
he's got
Correct.
Football figured out. Although that
out.
Is a backup.
Yep, that's Hammond. Ball on the ground. And they're going to recover. That's going to be the defenders picking up the loose ball fumble. There's a flag on the play, though. That's number 5, Sherrod. He's going to be all over the field trying to get some positive yards. And Hanley with the fumble.
Hanley with an 8-yard.
Let's see what the officials talk about.
Brendan Hanley with about an 8-yard gain.
That penalty going to go on the defenders.
But I believe they will still keep the ball.
Yep, it's going to be after the play or after the fumble recovery.
That 8-yard rush puts Deckerville up to 400 yards rushing unofficially.
There you go, 400-0 through the air.
Do it on the ground if you have to, and you know.
I like your little analogy from earlier. If there's gold in the front yard, why dig in the back?
Yep. My former coach from Arlac, Terry Reed, I'm sure you've heard
yes,
of him.
Yes, definitely.
Great guy. Miss him a lot. I mean, he passed away, I believe, a year ago, last year. Just a great guy, great knowledge. He has a lot of great sayings.
And, I like it.
And that was one where if my hook shot was working and I tried to do something fancy else, he'd be, if you found gold in the front yard, don't go digging in the backyard. And there's a lot of times he told me that, so that one stuck with me.
That's awesome. Yeah, I'll give you the cell phone number. Just send me text or your one-liners anytime you get
All
it.
Right, I'll have to send them. There's some good ones.
First and 10 for the defenders. Going to look back to pass. Fires over to the left side. That pass complete at midfield. Number 25.
So about a 12-yard gain through the air.
That's Wedevin. Nick Wedevin. I hope I got that correct. The freshman, he is part of that co-op with Calvary Schools of Holland. Eddie's going around trying to get the wireless mic to get down in the field. He's walking back.
I can't find how to get to the Tri-Unity offense. There we go. So that was a pass play for 12 yards.
Yes.
To number 25.
To number 25, yes, sir.
That's his second reception, but only 12 yards.
They do get a fresh set of downs. Ball goes over midfield now to the 48-yard line. That's going to be the Eagles' 48. Back of the shotgun is Sherrod. He looks to fire, tries to get away, but he's going to be brought down for a sack. Big sack by the Eagles defense.
A 7-yard sack there. Do you give that for negative rush yards?
Yes.
That'd be minus 7.
Yes, give that for the negative. Yep, because he's going to use that as a carry. Since
I know it sucks.
Quick.
It sucks in fantasy when your quarterback gets sacked or is even taking knees at the end of the game.
Yep.
You got to be careful there.
Don't worry about it if you're in the ESPN league, because they only don't do decimals.
True.
They only do whole numbers, so you don't get messed
up. That's what I'm in. My team started the year hot, struggling lately. The Oakland Golden Grizzlies got to pick it up. That's my team name. I was always the Marlette Red Raiders through high school. And
I cannot say my team name on air because it's pretty bad now.
We are online, though.
We are online,
we
but
are
don't
online,
say it because it's not good. It started off as Hopkins Island, and it goes now with Brock. I ain't going to say the rest of it because he's not good. Oh, it's terrible. And I even trade away my player. So we now face a second and a long ways. Sherrod, he's in the shotgun. He's in the handoff coming around the right end, number 9. He'll get maybe not even a positive yards. So number 9, the ball carrier, that'll be Benson Heath, a sophomore. No gain in the play. You put him down to 0?
I put him as minus 1 just because that's going to give credit to the Deckerville defense to show how well they've actually played here all day. Unofficially, 23 rushes for Wyoming, only 37 yards. That averages just over a yard a carry. But then through the air, 9 passes for 70 yards. Still, good defensive effort by the Eagles.
Just 107 total yards in for the defenders. Ball's going to be complete at the 40.
Loss of 5 on the play.
Complete yard
to Heath.
Yep, is that good? Number 9 again. Benson Heath, the sophomore.
And that was really good discipline there by the Eagles. Obviously, they've gotten pressure all game long, but when you get that screen pass, you really get the pressure.
Yes.
And their linebacker taking the back out of the backfield. Everybody did their assignment just as Bill Brown would want.
Because it's always going to be one-on-one matchup. Broken tackle was a touchdown.
Yes, especially in 8-man. And before, 8-man was all about who has two athletes. If you have two athletes back in the early days when CPS would win,
yes,
all you needed was two athletes. Bill Brown has kind of changed the mentality of 8-man football for the whole state because
it has.
It isn't one or two guys. Obviously, Fritz is having a great day and so are the other backs, but it's because of this defense, really.
Good defense. He introduced the power run game into 8-man football.
And we're going to get a 2-minute warning timeout by Tri-Unity.
All right. You right there, Eddie?
Searching for the microphone, but maybe it's in his car.
Timeout, that timeout under Tri-Unity Christian defenders. They're going to face a big fourth down in a long, long ways.
Fourth down, and you got to get to Harbor Beach for a first. And
pretty much.
And the only way you can get to that is on a full tank of gas, and I don't think they have it left in them.
They don't have to go all the way to Harbor Beach, at least to Ruth, to get the first down. Either way, a long ways. What's that saying? Fourth and how long on the scoreboard?
Fourth and 22.
Fourth and 22 with how many minutes to go?
2 minutes to play. 36-0 here. Deckerville on the lead. And none of these fans from Deckerville have left, even though it's 36-0.
No,
it's still packed.
They're looking for that big celebration right in midfield.
I wouldn't be surprised if they rushed the field afterwards.
They did last night in Elginac. Everybody came on the field.
Everybody. Probably a slow walk over on rush on the field because of the swamp. Have to get out all that swampy water.
Right.
But, and I mean, Tri-Unity still here supporting their team.
They're building up for a nice return next year, the next couple years with such a bunch of underclassmen. Fourth and a long, long ways. Sherrod, he's going to try to fire the ball, just trying to get away. Comes up to midfield, past midfield, past the 45 to the 40. He's going to be almost the first down. Ball's on the ground, though.
Ooh, I don't know about that fumble. It looked like he was reaching for the first down and hit it on the ground.
Okay, down by
the ground. They're going to give him the fumble down to the 30, so that's going to be.
That'll be a first down, then.
That'll be a first down, and I'm going to give him 22 yards on that rush.
All right, Mark.
They got extra on.
And they had him. They had him back in the backfield.
And that is Sherrard's 17th rush, 62 yards, an average of 3.65.
On first down, he'll throw. Receiver is not ready for that ball. Incomplete. What's that guy's last name? Number 24, Colin?
Decline. Declin. A freshman.
Declin.
A freshman.
Yep.
As you said earlier, this Tri-Unity team, very young. Obviously, they've got their quarterback, Sherrod, as a senior, and they got number 7, Brandon Pinder, as a senior, and a couple others, but that's all they have. And to have this great of a year, if you can find somebody that can fill Sherrod's shoes.
Man, I think they will.
You're going to be right back here next year and the years to come. Second and 10 here, trips left. And again, just that pressure in there, not giving him time to throw, but Sherrod's going to get away. He's going to go down the field inside the 20 to the 10, and he is into the end zone for a touchdown. And I know Bill Brown's not happy about that one.
Nope, wanted to have a shutout, but he gave up the shutout.
They're going to win the game, but...
That but coming from the 30-yard line.
And I know Bill Brown's not happy about that one.
Nope, wanted to have a shutout, but he gave up the shutout.
They're going to win the game, but...
That coming from the 30-yard line. Welcome back. We are live for our post-game show. Eddie's going to go down the field, try to grab Coach Brown, ring him up. Connor and I will do some stats. I'll start first. This MHSAA High School Football Playoffs are brought to you by the Michigan National Guard. And they, under the disclaimer, I'm trying to remember the disclaimer off my head... no reproductions.
Retransmissions.
Yep, reprints or anything of that fashion. Unless you had the written consent of MHSSA High School Football and the Thumb Tailgater Sports. So that's good enough for that disclaimer.
Quickly, Eddie's trying to get Bill Brown up here. We don't have much time left on our webcast. Going through the stats, Tri-Unity, they rushed the ball 25 times for 89 yards. 10 pass completions for 65 yards. Total offense, 150 total yards of offense. Deckerville, 37 rushes, 400 yards, no passes. Big game out of Austin Fritz, 19 carries for 266 yards and 14-yard average. Other stats here, 11 carries for 48 yards for Saldana. Brandon Patello, 5 carries for 73 yards, and Chase Patello even in there for 1 for 5.
There you go. You don't need to throw it in the air when you got it working on the ground.
Exactly. 400 like yards, unofficial 400 yards.
On just 37 carries.
On 37 carries. Any day that happens, that's a good day
that's
for
efficient.
Deckerville football. Sure. Eddie is on his way up with Bill Brown.
Good job again by defensive head coach Dan Brown. And, of course, the rest of the coaches there. You really disrupted his rhythm out there. That was the key, to disrupt Tri-Unity Christian's rhythm out there, wasn't it?
Well, you're talking a team that's averaged 56 points a game throughout the season. So for us to take that team on and be able to do that, because they have some weapons and they had the two or three fastest kids on the field, able to contain them. And special teams even came into play like we thought. We had one turnover, but we were able to stick with our defense.
Special teams. You called a timeout around that. Was that the discussion? You said, let's try to go for an onside kick here. You guys
No, not necessarily. Kick, no? There a couple of times, when we had the wind to our back, we didn't want to kick it down and not get into the end zone, because with Sherrod, with a lot of space like that and the ball don't get down there, that kid, you saw the last drive, he's pretty special in open field. So the conversation was, can we get to the end zone? Yes, but if we can't, we had a lead at that time. Defense is playing well. Let's just pooch it over there. And, we've done that all year. We'll pooch it over there, and sometimes we get a bounce, sometimes we don't, but at least you didn't get a return.
Speaking of special kids, how about that line? Austin Fritz said this when we last talked to him on video against Weber. He goes, I don't get these yards without my line out there. This is a line that we've been together. You said these guys were boys last year. They become men this year. Austin Fritz, 266 total yards rushing. He's got 4 touchdowns. Patello, we talked about this. He does have over 400-plus yards, but you didn't want to have to – throughout the whole season, just have him lean on him the whole time. You spread the ball out well enough, but Austin Fritz has been great. 266 yards, four touchdowns. But he said that offensive line has been key throughout the whole season.
Hey, and when they're putting everybody in the box like that, if we're blocking and being physical, when things open up, there's nobody left. You know, and Austin, Austin was actually he broke a couple tackles today, of course, you know, getting those scores. But, no, it starts up front. We got a lot of those kids that were back from last year. Bring in the addition of Curtis Vogel as a sophomore, but he is getting better. He is probably his most improved player maybe right now. The kid really has played well at guard for us. And then we brought in Asher at the center, and he's doing a great job. Big kid, too. And he's in just the last 2 weeks. We're seeing a lot of improvement out of our kids. So, and that's what you need. You just can't – and that was a big thing throughout the week. You know, we have to change from last week. I don't think we've played that well, even the first two games of the playoffs there. So, I don't think last year we changed as a team going in the semifinal. I think we were just staying the same, accepting we were there. This week we wanted to improve, and I think we did it in every aspect of the game.
And you added Durinko with the passing game a little bit and taking the running game away from Brandon Patel, but you haven't had to use that, thankfully. That's Deckerville's strength is run, 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 ground and pound. But you do have that in your back pocket. You hate to look far ahead, but you're going to state championship game. First of all, congratulations on that.
Oh, thank you. Thank
you're going you. Up against a perennial power, though, Powers North
right.
Central.
Well, we've been there, too.
Yeah.
They've only won one. We've won one. There will be no, I know they have a lot of talent. I think we got some kids, too. We're going to be the best defense we've played all year. We're not going to go in all wide-eyed and say, we're going over there. We're gonna go next couple days, relax a little bit. But we're going there to win it. We aren't going to stay in awe because he is great. He's a fantastic athlete, their quarterback, and much like today. And it's going to be the same. You're almost the same game plan type thing. You know, where you have got to keep the ball away from the kid. The kid's good. You know.
Well, congratulations back to Greenville, seeking a second straight or a second state championship. It's got to be gratifying that this is your third straight state semifinal. Some heartbreak, you're in a blizzard. Of course, you lost to Battle Creek St. Philip at Battle Creek on their home field. How was the host your own state semifinal here in your home field?
It was great. It was great. And, it's not like winning a double overtime game like we did it at over to Portland there in 2012, but it was great to see us execute, especially early, get the job done. And I was just down talking to Austin Spatzel with about 2 minutes left, how many games and what career he's had here. And even Reese Bates-Crazer was moved up as a sophomore, Those boys, they've done it all. Now we're going to the state championship. I'm proud of the boys. I'm glad they're getting the opportunity because they're definitely a special group, and hopefully we can finish this thing out.
Well, somebody up in heaven is looking down on you. Proud here,
she
Coach.
Is.
So congratulations. We'll see you next Friday night in Greenville State Championship game.
Thank you for covering us.
All right. Head Coach Bill Brown there of the Deckerville Eagles. And they are going to the state championship game here. They're going up against Powers North Central, the defending state champions. Deckerville Eagles are back at it. State championship game. And they are taking on Powers North Central Friday, November 18th. We'll be live on Channel 1 on Thumbtail Sports. Tune in at 6:30 p.m. Friday, November 18th on a Friday night, and it's a final. Ithaca loses to Frankenmuth, and Frankenmuth goes to a state semifinal also. Some great Thumb area teams making it to the upper echelon. That has not happened in quite a long time.
Yeah, I mean, that's great for Thumb athletics as a whole. Shows other sports, not just football as in general, but some of these basketball teams that start up in baseball and softball, that you can make a run from the Thumb.
Well, but our game here tonight, today, this afternoon, Deckerville winning over Trinity Christian, 36-6. You guys went through the stats, right?
We did, yes.
Okay.
400 total rushing yards.
Wow.
That's all Deckerville needed offensively, no
and,
passes.
You talked about Trinity Christian. They had their problems, 89 total yards rushing, 65 total yards passing, and the lone touchdown by Braden Sherrod with a touchdown near the end of the fourth quarter there, making it 36-6. But Austin Fritz, four touchdowns. Brandon Patello with the touchdown also for 58 yards. So the touchdown runs here for Austin Fritsch. As we look, he had a 70-yard touchdown run, an 18-yard touchdown run, a 24-yarder, and an 85-yard touchdown run. Austin Fritsch, leading rusher for 266 yards.
And
Deckerville winning over Trinity Christian 36-6.
And you look at Deckerville, they had five different guys carry the ball. And with a two-back set and a quarterback, most of the time you're only going to get three. But when you can spread the ball around, a lot of different angles can attack you.
Well, Mikey Smith is holding the camera right now. You have anything to say there, Mikey?
I'm good.
All right. Well, I want to thank everybody for tuning in to Channel 1 on thumbtugger.com. Well, next week we have Friday night game, state championship game in eight-player football, Powers North Central. The defending state champions in eight-player football from last year taking on Deckerville Eagles. They'll be on Thumbtugger Channel 1. And then Saturday we'll have a state semifinal game. We'll be covering Division 5, Algonac taking on the winner of Grand Rapids West Catholic or Berrien Springs. Connor Thomas, thanks for coming here today.
Thanks for having me. Fun day.
Mikey Smith right there by the camera. I am Eddie Fury. And thank you for tuning in to Thumbtugger Sports once again. Deckerville winning the state semifinal South Division over Tri-Duty Christian 36-6. Thank you for tuning in to Thumbtailgater Sports.